the Animal Welfare League, dogs can find themselves homeless for all kinds of reasons. And today is no different.
Hey, Bri. Hey, how's it going?
Good. Who have we got here?
So they've all been an owner surrender. Unfortunately, one of the dogs in the home, they weren't getting on too well with. A few of them do have a couple battle wounds, so we're going to have to get them attended to. One of the dogs that came in today is a little Maltese Terrier, and his name is Harlie. He's matted and he's got lesions and cuts all over him. He's really shut down and it looks like he's only got one eye.
Yeah, you can see that. So we're going to get them out now?
Yeah, awesome.
Good job, guys.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
It's so sad to see dogs come in this state.
Come on, guys.
It really makes you think, what kind of life did they have beforehand to be so neglected? But as soon as they come into our care, the healing can begin.
The Animal Welfare League on Sydney's Western Fringe is the home of second chances.
She's a little Australian Terrier mix.
I don't even know what that is.
Here, dedicated staff and volunteers match the orphaned and abandoned with their forever families.
Hi.
Oh, hello.
Can't believe this, I'm crying.
And while sometimes it's a mess, there's no mistaking true love when it strikes straight to the heart.
My beautiful boy.
I love you.
We're going to take you home.
Are you excited?
Can you hear the dogs?
Can I get doggy?
The Vilkins family are hoping to find the perfect playmate for their little boy.
We're looking for a dog for Shepherd. Hopefully a dog that will bring out Shepherd's spark.
This is Sheppy.
Sheppy, hi Sheppy.
He's the reason we're here.
Oh, nice to meet you. And how old is Sheppy?
Sheppy will be 5 in April.
Oh, wow. And do you guys all live together?
Yeah.
Yes. I might be biased, but Sheppy has a beautiful personality. He's so musical. He loves music. He loves books. He loves cars. He loves dancing.
Go with Mummy.
So he likes Mummy's, like, you know, One Direction and High School Musical and, yeah.
She's had the opportunity to influence his taste more than I have, unfortunately.
But he loves dogs, absolutely loves dogs.
Hi.
Hello.
So we're here for a dog?
Yes.
Yes.
Perfect.
Karin is a therapy dog.
Perfect. Great.
Personality-wise, what we're looking for dog is obviously a dog that's going to be great with children, because we've got a child with a disability who's non-verbal. I would love like a larger type of dog, like a golden retriever, Labrador, Kelpie, border collie, okay. German Shepherd.
That size?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yep. An intelligent breed, mainly an intelligent breed that sure. we could potentially train.
Yep. So what would you like to get out of the therapy dog?
So Sheppy, he's been through a lot.
Mm-hmm.
We've love to get him to be a bit more interactive again.
Yeah.
We're looking for the dog to bring more fun into his life and show him how to play a bit more.
He's obsessed with a show called Waffle the Wonder Dog. And he's non-verbal, but he said waffle when he saw the dog. His therapist was like, did you just hear that? Did he just say waffle? And so we're hoping that, you know, hopefully having a dog will bring out more speech from him and bring out his little personality.
Who's going to make the final decision here on if we do take the dog home?
Probably me.
Probably you?
Probably, yeah.
Nice. Or maybe Dad, I think. Yeah. The best way to describe Dad is he's a rock. He's our rock.
He helps clean, he cooks, and he looks after the Sheppy. We couldn't live without him.
He's always, wherever I go, and he'll be behind me, and I love it. Everybody loves it.
You're going to be the child wrangler and the dog wrangler.
Lovely, lovely family. They've got a son named Shepherd. He's non-verbal currently.
Yeah.
So they're really looking for that perfect dog to be a companion. They're looking for a therapy dog.
Basically, we're hoping that the dog's going to teach Sheppy, like, basic skills on how to play and interact.
What was their favourite breed?
So they really love their labs. They love their golden retrievers, collies, kelpies.
Yeah.
Got Rusty. so gentle, but also very active.
He's a beautiful. Oh,
he's got the best ears when he's in his kennel and they're like this.
Cute.
He's come from a farm originally, so he's super active. So he might be a bit too active for the family.
What about little Seth?
He's 5 months old. He's a German Shepherd mix. He loves his naps, loves food, and absolutely loves the beach.
Sounds like me. Seth's been here 3 months now. He had a bout of parvo, fought that, and eventually came around.
Parvovirus is a really deadly disease, especially in immunocompromised animals such as puppies. Seth was really close to passing, unfortunately, so we're very lucky he came in. He was so tiny, so fragile. It's so important we find him a home as soon as we can now.
He's come a long way.
Oh, he's a little fighter. Like Sheppy.
How fitting is that? I think he'd make a great therapy dog. He's so smart, so clever.
Team Seth.
Team Seth.
Found you the perfect little match.
Okay. He's 6 months old. He's a smart little breed. He's really sweet, loving, good with kids, good with dogs.
Sounds good.
So Seth came to us with a virus, so he was quite ill as a puppy. Oh. He did almost actually die. So he is a true blue fighter.
Yeah.
He has put in the hard yards and he has made it through the other end.
Like you.
Yeah, he's a really perfect match for little Sheppy. He is a German Shepherd.
No. Well, yes. German Shepherd was his dream breed. Great.
There you go. Are you guys ready? Do you want to meet him?
Yes, please. Yeah. Great. All right. Let's go.
Tear Sheppy away from the book. I'm hoping it's love at first sight.
Let's go, buddy.
I believe in love at first sight. I think if I see the dog, you know instantly if it's the right match. You'll have a connection, I think. I'm gonna see a doggy. When Shepherd was born, he was immediately having 100 seizures a day.
That's like perfect age, isn't it?
They said that they were suspecting a stroke. And after the MRI, they told us how big it was, the stroke.
Come on, we're going to see your doggy.
Because of the stroke on the left side of the brain.
Most of that side of the brain.
Was gone.
Was gone.
Good boy, Sheppy.
Cry. It was our first kid. And Sreda was always telling me that things will change when you're a dad. They change more than I expected.
Wow, this is cool.
The neurologist said that Shepherd is a candidate for a surgery called hemispherectomy. It's where, in Shepherd's case, pretty much they were going to remove the left side of Shepherd's brain.
Gotta go sit down.
So there was a risk that Shepherd wouldn't be able to talk after surgery.
You gonna wait for your doggy?
You want to explore, do you?
I wonder if he'll be interested.
I hope so. That really was quite terrifying.
Where are you going?
And yes, it's tough and it's difficult at times and we've had our challenges. But we have our child, and we can hold him, we can kiss him, we can love him.
Whee! He's proud of himself when he does something new. He used to clap himself, he couldn't use both hands, so he'd clap himself in the chest.
Excited?
The determination that he has is awesome.
You gonna see a doggy?
Hi, beautiful.
Seth is a very energetic, bubbly little boy. He's very playful. He loves his food. Good boy. Seth was very malnourished when he came in. Luckily, he's put some weight on and he's a very, very lucky boy to be here today. He is good with kids. He's good with dogs. He's just an all-round sweet little pup.
Good work. Let's go. Come on, baby.
a lot of pressure here. There's a lot riding on this, both for Seth being through so much, and then obviously we have to pick the right animal for this family.
Preparing for the chance that there won't be a connection, it's a bit hard. It's like dating in almost a way. You hope that they like you, but you can never really make them like you. Just let them come to you and try and be as open as you can.
Are you excited? Let's go. Sheppy. You go meet them. Is the doggy coming?
Harlie the Maltese Terrier found himself at AWL after an owner surrender.
Little Harlie has been in our care for a couple weeks now and he's really starting to come out of his shell. He still doesn't like to be touched because he is in pain. Harlie came in quite a state and his mats were quite down to his skin, so it has been a little hard to groom him. In cases like this, we usually give the dogs a little bit more time to settle in before taking them down to the vets.
Look at you. Hello. Hello, little man. Get you all organised, Mr. Harlie, hey? Oh, good boy. Oh, look at the mats here. It's all little bits of stick and twigs and seeds and things in there, which would be really uncomfortable. I don't see many like this, so it's pretty bad. Get so matted, they get eye infections and it causes them to lose their eye too. Good little man. Well, I don't think I'd get any prizes as a barber, but he looks a lot better than he did. He'll make somebody a good little dog.
Hi, handsome.
Oh, you look like a totally different dog. Harlie, he came out with the biggest bounce in his step. He had so much swagger. It feels really amazing to be able to help the dogs feel confident and happy again. It is the best part of the job, I reckon.
Hey, cutie, come on.
The Vilkins are hoping a rescue dog will help their son Sheppy after his life-changing surgery.
After surgery, he surprised everyone. He started talking like he never talked before. He was having conversations with us. And unfortunately now, he has regressed. His speech is gone and his little personality is gone. His little spark is gone. And so we're hoping that getting a rescue dog that's just for Sheppy will hopefully bring some sort of spark back.
Good boy. This way. Sheppy. Is the doggy coming? Good.
Hi.
Hi.
Good boy. How you doing, guys?
I might grab Sheppy.
Yeah, no, that's okay. Hi, Baba.
Hey, buddy.
So this is Seth. He is a gorgeous German Shepherd cross. He was very, very scared and skittish when he first came into care, so it does take him a little bit longer to warm up.
Sheppy looks very interested, doesn't he?
He does.
He's like, he's a treat. Eyes locked on, isn't he?
Good boy.
I hope it goes all right, because I know Seth, he's a bit standoffish at first. Once he's comfortable, he's actually a really sweet dog.
Yeah.
So the best thing to do is just to give him his space, maybe ignore him a little bit, let him have a sniff, and let him come up to you in his own time.
Good boy.
It's all right.
I know. I'm okay.
Hard for Sheppy. So Sheppy's unverbal as well.
Shep just seems to really like those leaves. Yeah. But he looks over every so often, has a little smile.
Alright, so if you're happy, I'll drop the lead so that he can come see you guys, but I can grab him if I need to at any point.
Go for it, Papa.
Yeah.
Oh, easy, Papa.
Careful.
Sheppy. Yeah. That's Sheppy. Oh.
Finally, huh? Yeah.
After waiting his whole life, Bien has finally talked his mum and dad into getting a dog.
You're going to allow them to sleep on your bed, right?
No.
For me, this is 20-odd years in the making, so this is just going, yes, finally a dog.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hi, how are you?
Like a can tell you guys love your bling.
Yes. Yeah.
Comes from Mum.
100%, I can see it. And how would you describe your family?
He's the boss. He's the CEO.
Okay,
so...
Yes, Mum realises it.
Yeah. I'm the queen.
And the bank.
And who wants the dog the most?
You're already looking. I'm Seth's dog across the board. Now it's probably a really good time to get a dog because I think a child for me or a kid for me is probably not on the cards at the moment in time. So I think the next best thing is probably a dog.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
So I think a dog will definitely change my life in many ways. Mum, Dad, myself, we become extra close. As close as we are now and just as much as I love them, I think this dog just brings an extra dimension to the family dynamic.
Yeah. He looks like...
That's a...
Oh, careful. Easy, Papa.
Careful.
Yeah, look, that's Sheppy. Oh.
Guys,
over here.
Come on. Look at the big smile. Look at the big smile on his face.
That's really sweet.
It was a good interaction.
Yeah.
Seth was saying
hello. Come on,
Seth. Sheppy taught me. There's a lot of hurdles. There's a lot of hard things. Some people are going to say that you can't, won't be able to do it. Try anyway.
Seth, over here.
Sheppy.
Seth.
Look.
Hey. Oof.
Good boy. He's eating treats from his hand.
Oh, look at him.
That's a little bit cute.
Oh, that is really cute.
He's very gentle with him.
It's a leaf.
Oh, he's going to steal the leaf.
Yeah, you're doing well, buddy, aren't you?
Is that right?
I think this is perfect. I don't think we're going to find a dog that is as better suited than Seth is for them.
Sheppy is so happy. Like, he's brighter. He's a brighter child with that big dog around.
Found the spark.
Yeah.
The relationship between the dogs connect with kids on a level that we can't provide for Sheppy. And I'm really looking forward to see what that brings out of Sheppy.
How would you guys feel about taking him for a bit of a walk?
Yeah,
awesome.
The connection between Sheppy and Seth can probably grow from here.
The decision for me is a little bit harder. I'm still on the fence about it.
Convinced his parents to add another member to the family.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you guys. And what are we doing here today?
Hopefully adopting a dog.
Yeah, what will the rescue's life look like with you guys?
Here we go.
It's going to be pampered, I think.
Yes, spoiled is probably the big one.
Nice.
We're full of love, all of us, like Mum and Dad particularly.
Yeah.
Oh, how I describe my parents. Definitely very, like, caring and selfless. Both of my parents go out of their way to just care for a lot of other people. Mum's never really wanted a dog back when I was younger, so now she's kind of flipped the page.
Why didn't you want to?
I had a little accident that traumatized me.
Oh, sorry to hear.
We have a German Shepherd when I was young. She was massive. And, you know, I think she was just being playful and jumped on me and, you know.
Scared you.
And wounded me. So when that happened,
Mum used to see a dog on the walkway when we were walking out in the block. And as soon as she saw it, she'd dart across the other side of the road.
Or I hide behind someone's back. And I said, there's a dog. You go first, you know?
So what's changed then?
My age? And
okay. Oh, well. And what are our favourite breeds? Do we all agree on the same type of dog or are you a bit different?
Definitely, if I could pick from the lot, I'd definitely go for a blue staff.
Oh, okay. Definitely very different.
We've agreed on kind of like a small to medium sized dog. You can kind of enjoy his time on our laps.
Yeah. And something to put up tutu on.
No tutus.
So I guess then breed's not super important for you guys, just as long as it sort of fits your lifestyle?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Like a short head. We don't really want to go out looking nice, and then there's all hair on our
So no huskies.
Yeah, high shedding's a bit of a deal breaker for us.
Yeah.
I kind of want to maintain the cleanliness of our house and whatnot as well.
Yeah, so. Yeah, okay. Yeah. We might go and have a chat with our manager and then find your dream tutu dog.
Oh, yeah. Is that?
This is like a big one.
And that's why we're all excited to get one, because it's a learning process, you know?
Yeah, because...
Oh, why are you looking at me like that? See? How annoying he is.
I love these guys. Mum used to be terrified of dogs. She had an incident with a shepherd.
Yeah.
And so she used to, you know, cross the road to avoid dogs and things like that. Oh, but she's really flipped and she's really excited for a dog.
Okay. Did they mention any favourite breeds?
Ben's favourite breeds are blue staffies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So we have Hayley.
She's super friendly, so she's 2 years old. She's unusually relaxed for a staffy and would be suited to any family, including kids or elderly, due to how well she walks on lead. They did say that they want to take her to dog parks and on walks with other dogs.
She couldn't go to a dog park. She has had, I guess, a history of when dogs do approach her too quickly, that she might have a bit of a snap.
Yeah.
And maybe just something medium to small, considering that the mum had had a bit of an incident and is working her way up to bigger dogs.
Okay, but yeah. I don't think she's quite right choice. I would be looking at Banjo.
Here's Banjo.
He's cute.
So cute. He's so handsome. So he's our one-year-old male pug cross-French bulldog. So he's good with cats, he's good with dogs, and he's on the active side.
Their home would be ideal, and it's quite rare that we get people saying they're happy to have the dog predominantly inside, so I kind of want to jump on that.
Banjo is probably the right choice.
Yeah, I think so.
Alright, Ben, we found you.
Awesome.
A little brother.
Wow.
Be the favourite son anymore. He's just over one.
Yeah, he's goofy, fun, and definitely smoochy. You are.
Tick. Tick there.
So did you say it's a boy?
It's a boy.
What happened to Tutu?
I mean, I feel like this breed could totally rock a tutu.
Oh, definitely.
Hey, they can?
Yeah. Oh, no. So he is a pug cross French bulldog.
Oh, no.
Beautiful.
So, yeah, not a breed we get in too often, and he's not been here too long, so it's just perfect timing for you guys, really.
What was his name, by the way? Does he have a name?
Banjo.
Banjo.
Oh. Banjo.
Little Banjo.
Ben and Banjo.
Banjo.
Growing up, Mum's always not wanted a dog because she's always scared.
Yeah, thank you.
And just bit by bit, I guess, she's chipped away at that fear.
Do you think you get along with Mum, you reckon?
Yes.
You've never really seen a Frenchie, have you?
Nah.
You were a little bit excited then?
Similar with that, then.
Ready?
Wow.
They seem like a quite close family.
Yeah,
they are. They're really close. They're always laughing.
Dad, when you first see Banjo walk through the door, what are you going to do? 3, 2,
here he comes, Banjo.
Hi, puppy boy.
Banjo is quite a character. Right on cue. He's got that real quirky personality that pugs have. He's really excited. The second you go into his kennel, he just wants to be out and about and meeting every single person. And he's got these funny little ears that look like they've been stuck on too close together. Banjo. Ideal home would be somewhere that he could be predominantly indoors. Just because he is a pug mix, so they do have the flutter face, they do struggle in the heat. And he loves the bum scratches. Oh, is that a good spot? Is that a good spot?
So, Mum, when you see Banjo, what are you going to show us?
I'm going to test the water first. I'm still a little bit edgy still. I'm still in denial if I'm going to get a dog because Bien really pushing me to have a dog.
When Banjo, when Banjo walks in, you're just gonna sit there like this?
I'm just gonna look first.
Thank you, Banjo. Let's go.
Here we go.
Oh my God.
Really excited.
excited.
Karin has been searching for a four-legged companion for over a year.
I'm a 66-year-old lady who loves talking.
Hey, welcome to AWL.
Thank you. I'm all excited good. To be here. My nickname was Have a Chat at work, so I like to talk. I love gardening. I love motorbikes.
And feel free to just pop yourself right over here, okay?
Yeah. It's the freedom of being out on the road. That exhilarating feeling. You got the wind in your face. It's just the best feeling in the world to ride a motorbike.
Oh, the labby. Hello, baby.
Do you honestly reckon, like, your whole life you thought you would never ever go?
No.
Thank you, baby. Let's go. Let's go.
Here we go. Here we go.
The Tomples are hoping to complete their family with Banjo, the pug cross.
Good boy.
Look at his ears.
Sit down for me if that's okay.
Look at his ears.
So if you want to stay nice and still and just let Banjo kind of check you guys out.
He's barking.
He's like, oh my god.
He says, guys, calm down.
What happened?
Good job.
Hello.
Good work. I'm just going to let him off and let him kind of do his own thing.
Yeah.
So you were a bit scared of dogs, were you, prior?
Yes.
Oh, no.
He's
so what we want to avoid is just, we don't want to lean over the top of him and, you know, things like that that might be a bit scary.
Yeah.
You're welcome to get down to his level and let him approach you.
Yeah, hello.
Right, thank you.
Thanks for cuties. Hey, where are we going?
Come on.
Hey, Dad, get a couple of treats, hey? Come here, champion. Here, we'll come. We'll go. Banjo.
Aww.
Where you going, Banjo? Banjo, come here.
Miriam's still at the back there.
Yeah.
And she's still a bit fearful.
What do you reckon, Mum? Do you think it's cute now?
Very nice, huh?
Yeah.
I've been hanging on to that fear for long. So you just have to overcome it, and then I just kind of block it off, you know, because I have to face it, you know. Come.
Look at that.
She's doing the right thing by sitting down and being nice and calm.
Come.
Mm-hmm. He's giving you a kiss. Look at that.
Oh, look at him.
Mm-hmm.
Let him give you kisses. Let him give you kisses, Mum.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Miss Pat. She's definitely conquered her fear, hey?
Yeah.
I'm proud of her.
Banjo,
come
here. Oh, you're a bit tired now, huh?
I go.
Oh, you want that?
Oh look.
He just tucked himself in. That is the funniest thing ever.
Come here.
Ready, watch it. I'm pouring out there. Banjo, come here. Ready? Come here. Up.
Wow, good boy.
So cute. I'm happy that he likes BM because, like, it's going to be his baby. It's going to be all of their baby, but mostly BM.
This is nothing, it's just disturbing.
Oh, yeah, he does.
Every time Manny pats Banjo, he looks down at his hands.
They did say that they like dressing up to go out and they don't want hair on their nice clothes, their going out clothes.
They're going
to
be covered in hair.
They're going to have hair on them.
Yeah.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
How are you all doing? Oh, hello, little man.
Oh, it's the best.
I probably don't have to ask, but would you like to take him for a walk?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah? Amazing.
Shedding for us was a bit of a, I guess, in terms of taking Banjo home, I think that's a big discussion that all three of us will take.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi. What are you doing here today?
I'm here hopefully to find my forever fur baby.
Oh, that's great. How exciting.
I'm very excited.
What made you choose to come to a rescue?
You can buy puppies and that, but it's not the same. Rescuing a dog is showing them that they've got a new, you know, there is people out there that'll love them and care for them and give a doggy a loving home.
I get depressed at times because I can't do what I used to do. But I think having a little dog in my life
will take my mind off that pain.
And is it just yourself at home?
Yes, there is.
Yeah?
It's lonely.
Yeah, of course.
Want a little dog.
Do you have, like, could you list me off some of your favourite breeds?
I've always had Labradors or big dogs growing up.
Yeah.
But any breed.
You like them all?
Yes,
so I love dogs. So breeds are important, just, I guess.
I just love dogs.
Yeah.
I need a sweet little calm dog that will be there for me, that won't jump on me too much because of my now disability. And I hate that word. As you can see, I'm in a wheelchair.
Yeah.
I can walk a little bit. I use crutch at home.
Yeah.
I'm not in the chair at home.
Yeah.
It's only when I go out that I'm in the chair.
Sure. Is there anything you're nervous about on this journey of finding your dream pooch?
That I won't find one again. And
oh, okay.
That's all, yeah. I've been looking for so long and I'm just scared that I won't find a little dog.
We might go and have a chat and find you your dream dog. We won't be too long.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Karin. So she is a wheelchair user.
Yeah.
So it needs to obviously be someone that when she does go outside, it's not going to sort of pull too hard.
Yeah.
She can have sit on her lap.
What about Caroline?
She is quite small and sweet. Her coat just makes me laugh. So she's only two. She's an Australian Terrier mix.
As soon as she came in, I think she just went straight to foster.
Remember when she came up from foster, she actually put on a bit of weight. She's a little bit chunky. I don't think Karin will be able to pick her up one-handed.
There he is, little Harlie.
Harlie, I love you.
But something about Harlie, he's just such a sweet smoosh. Pick him up and carry him around.
I think he'd be really suited to sitting on Karin's lap, that's for sure.
He'd love her. He's got this little trot when you do have him walking by.
Yeah.
And he's just sweet.
Yeah, he is a favourite.
He's nine. He's a Maltese, which is a favourite breed of hers.
Yeah, okay.
He arrived in the shelter with only one eye, and we don't know why or what's happened. And he was quite shy as well, but has definitely come out of his shell.
He'd be pretty happy to live around the house and not go out much anyway.
Mm.
He's one of those dogs who just wants to be around people.
Yeah, I think he's a really good option.
Harlie, I think it is. This is the best option.
Okay. Let's go introduce Harlie.
Yay. Well, I'm Harlie.
So, we have found your little boy.
Yes. Oh,
he's a very social boy, so he's going to love spending time just being around you constantly.
Oh, I'm excited.
He's only small, so he's going to be easy to pick up and sit on your lap and toddle around behind you.
His name is Harlie, and he's nine. He's only got one eye. And he came into our care like that, and he gets around totally fine. But I think it's kind of cute.
Yeah, I don't think it affects him at all. Yeah. It makes him, gives him a bit of character as
well. Yeah, absolutely.
But he is a Maltese.
Oh. I had my heart really set on a Maltese.
Oh, great. That's excellent.
That's awesome.
Yeah. That works well, doesn't it?
I think
maybe we should get this started.
Let's
go. Alrighty.
I got my first motorbike back when I was 28. Boom, boom, boom. And that was it. That's when I fell in love with motorbikes. Almost there for me. Forever baby. My life changed a million times over on the 30th of August 2016. I finished work, got on my bike to go home. A young girl didn't look in her side mirror before she pulled out into my line of traffic. And my bike just slammed straight into the side of her car. I landed on the ground 20 metres away from where I hit the car on my back. And I woke up in the emergency ward of St Vincent's Hospital. I had a great life before the accident. My life is nothing like it was before. It never will be again. I can't work anymore. Wheelchair now. I now live alone in a big house, and all I want in my life now is a little dog to keep me company.
Oh, I hope it goes well.
Harlie! You ready?
Harley's quite aloof. Well, actually, we'll be surprised if he doesn't go over to Karin, which was, I hope doesn't deter her or anything.
I'm hoping that the little dog will come over to me and
while.
Oh, I'm getting excited.
That would be my wildest dream if a dog instantly came to me and wanted to climb over me and trying to give me doggy kisses. I love doggy kisses.
Retiree Karin is hopeful that her long search for a doggy soulmate is finally over.
There won't be any more bad days. They'll only be good days. Because I'll have a purpose in my life. Someone to look after. Someone to be responsible for again. And someone to give unconditional love to.
Harley is quite a bit aloof. I actually will be surprised if he doesn't go over to Karin. Which I hope doesn't deter her or anything.
Here he goes. He's so cute.
I can see little book.
You ready, mister? Your time. Hello, how are you?
Hello, little man. Hi, Harley.
This is Harley.
Hello, sweetheart. Oh, hello.
Ooh, he might surprise. He went straight up to her. That's
a little bit
good.
Surprising. It's good.
Hello, baby. Tiny little boy. Aren't you?
Are you comfortable if I let him off the leash for a little sniff?
Yeah.
Harley, come on.
Oh, she looks happy.
Harley loves toys. He loves to get that little, that one or the navy blue one. He loves to get really down and taste them.
What's she got?
Harley.
Look, Harley.
What's that?
What have I got?
Yeah, that's what I thought he'd do. So he'd just kind of walk around there.
He's quite the adventurer. I find him having a little bit of a sniff.
He's very aloof to start off with.
Harley, come on. What are you doing? What? Having a scratch.
Are you comfortable for me to leave you to here?
Yeah.
No problem.
What you doing, mate? Hey? You gonna explore? Harley?
I do wonder what she's thinking. Not sure she's completely sold just yet. When he does walk off and just doesn't really acknowledge Karin, you can see there's a lot of thought process going through her head.
Yeah.
Harley, come on, baby boy.
We know Harley so well, and even if he doesn't know the staff member too well, as soon as he sort of recognizes you, he'll bolt in and he does a little T-Rex where he jumps on his back legs and wants to be picked up.
What else is in here, Harley? Look. What's that? What's that one? Chew that one up.
Oh, look. He's having a play. That is so cute. And he wouldn't be, like, initiating like that if he wasn't comfortable with Karin.
No.
This takes him a while to trust someone well enough that he will play like this. So
that is so
I'm good. So impressed.
It's so cute.
We chew the pussycat up.
Yeah, Harley looks pretty comfortable, which is good to see. But I do like to see him around the wheelchair.
How are we going?
Oh,
I knew he'd love that toy. All right, well, we ready to go for a walk?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, mister, do you want to come here? We'll put you on lead.
Will I try him beside the chair or will I walk?
What are you comfortable with? Do you want to go on your chair or do you want to...
Yeah, we'll see how he goes with the chair.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, this will be interesting now to see what he's going to be like.
Yeah.
All right, Harley, you ready? Good boy. Look at that.
Look, Harley.
Do you want to follow with it? Come on, Harley.
Come on, Harley.
Follow this way. Good job. Come on. Good job. So we'll just head down around to the right. Come on, mister. Come.
Come on, Harley. Come on.
Come on. This way. We can do it.
Come on, Harley.
Good boy.
Oh, good boy, Harley.
No problem.
Harley, want to come up? Come on.
Oh, if he gets in there, that would be awesome.
Might be a bit easier. He does sit real easy. Yeah, there we go, Harley.
That's so cute.
now, mate. How's that? Why walk when we can ride?
Why walk when you can ride? That's great.
It looks like he's smiling. Look, his little tongue out.
Oh, that's actually so cute.
Yeah, where are we going?
Quite a bit of fur.
Freak me being like, oh, you know, going out of the house all the time, hair being everywhere.
The shedding for me is, I hate it. I really do. But that's little compared to the joy that he gives us.
Banjo, come out. Good boy.
If I knew this is the toy that you get from a dog.
Yes, you want that.
Maybe you would have convinced me a bit more earlier.
I've been trying to convince you my whole life.
So, yeah, that's... The shed is nothing.
Hey, yeah, look at the hair. Look. There.
Good hair on Mamita. Everywhere, huh?
He definitely is a member of the Tongo family now, and I don't see him disappearing.
No, don't bite me.
Everywhere we go around the house is always there. Whether you walk into the kitchen and grab a drink, or whether you walk to your bedroom or to the bathroom, he's following you.
Yeah, this way. Good boy.
We always go for a morning walk as well.
Oh, he loves walking.
He loves
walking. Yeah, he loves walking.
Can you two keep up, please? Let's go.
Before, I'm really scared of dogs. Really, big time. Now, it's gone. I think he's just the one who really broke that ice that opened my mind. Yeah, so I face the fear now. We're buddies. I'm the mamita of Benjo now.
Thanks, love.
You're welcome.
I was looking for a little dog that would keep me company, would be there for me 24/7. I used to spend most of my time just laying on the lounge or in bed, not moving at all very much because of my injuries. But now, what's mum got? Every morning, Harley wakes me up about 6 a.m., tail wagging a mile a minute, telling me, get out of bed, mum, and come and sit down and watch TV. Come on, we sit down and watch TV together. I didn't know what I was going to meet, and I have no regrets whatsoever about bringing Harley home. He's the best thing that's happened to me in 5.5 years. Harley, what have I got? Come on. My heart went out to him because he only has one eye. I knew I was going to keep him. He needed a home, someone to love him to bits. I was rescuing Harley, but more importantly, Harley was rescuing me. I gotcha, we're gonna go tatas. Harley's beside me most of the places I go. He loves riding up on the wheelchair. Yes. Best. Couldn't look forward to the next day, but now I look forward to every single day because Harley just fills my heart with love.
He owns the house and we just live there.
Will this real pooch find his perfect prince or princess?
Come on, Bruno.
An old-timer seeks his forever retirement home.
He's just a wonderful dog. If you want a companion, this is the dog for you.
You just never know, like, what's going to happen. So a little bit of hope goes a long way.
And will this beagle-ear cross biscuit find sweet love?
Oh, no way.
Biscuit, I don't know if he loves me or not.